Oh, truly. Kare.
Yes, asking His Holiness and also any of the Geshe's Rinpoche could also chip in if you have.
Hello. Okay. Yes. So now, I think I talk too much. Now let the other monk, I think, should speak. Yeah, that's good. Sure.
I don't want to be the first to start, but it happened to be like that because I'm sitting in the front of. I mean, we have basically.
I think, in Vinaya Sutra, the Sangha, at least is four bhikshus. That's important. Individual monk, not important. So no rank, no rank.
I have really nothing very particular to mention, but only I would like to express my joy that we are have been able to at least start with this wonderful initiative. And already, as His Holiness mentioned, this getting itself is a big initiative because we have spent so many hours discussing. And yesterday evening also, we sat in different groups and had a lot of exchange of ideas and sharing of information among each other's process of Vinaya, process of practice, and so forth. So this is a very good beginning. But then, as we have all agreed, it is not enough just to make a short-lived attempt and then completely get extinguished or died out. And so here, my humble suggestion is, I mean, not necessarily that we should continue with another big meetings and things like that. There is also another possibility. But what is really important is each and every one of us as individuals should show that genuine interest and deep appreciation. And I'm happy to say that already somebody contacted me willing to send one of the students to Dharamsala to study. So that is the process. So it could happen on the initiative of a monastery, or it could happen on the initiative of an individual monks. Now we know each other, so it's important that we exchange our addresses and cards and they continue to get more information and continue to give the contact flow. So, and what is most important thing is to do this exchange of idea with understanding that we are not doing this for the benefit of an individual person or for the benefit of the Tibetan Buddhists or benefit of the Thai Buddhists, but it is for the benefit of all sentient beings, as is the commitment and promise of all the Buddhist practices. So with that kind of understanding, realization, and knowledge, and with understanding that we are doing this for a good cause, for a great purpose. So with that understanding, I think we should come together and share our ideas continuously.
Then perhaps, I think, some sort of organization or some individual, I think, should sort of leave address. Then also is our institution, at least the three institutions, Sarnath Institution, Delhi Institution, yeah. Then here, Dharamsala Institution also. You see, they give that address, and then I think someone, individual, could take sort of responsibility to keep contact. Otherwise, you see, they let just individual. Then you also, I think, sometimes busy, so eventually forget.
Well, I guess that we got some picture here that we have from Thai side. I guess that we have at least originally from two universities. We have a director of the Vimuttalai. We have many abbots, the Mahachula and Mahamukut, and as well as Wat Pananachad. We have another meditation center in the Tama'o Temple. So we have so many abbots and institutions here, gathered here. And then I believe that everyone is very energetic, everyone is very young, and then we should pursue the collaborations. Of course, I guess that in order to facilitate those collaborations, we might ask the mediator as the Buddhadas archive, maybe play as a role of a mediator to bring together. Otherwise, as Your Holiness has mentioned, that sometime we go, at the moment we are in the heat level, everyone is very interested, but once we get into the plane, and then things faded away. So I guess that we need have that sort of thing. Talking about this collaboration, I guess that there is a few things I would like to remind all of us here based on the, what His Holiness has mentioned to us. I guess His Holiness emphasized on education. Education is a key for us to carry on Buddhism, not only sake of Buddhism itself, but the sake of all sentient beings. His Holiness mentioned about conversions. We are not here to convert anybody. But however, His Holiness mentions about being a Judeo-Christian, they can practice Buddhism. But there is one saying very clearly says that Buddhists make a good Christian. Buddhists make a good Muslim. Similarly, I think we need now is that how can Buddhism make a good Buddhist itself? One thing that. The second thing is that I think it is very important what His Holiness has mentioned to us that in terms of education, in terms of bringing that Buddhism alive, we need to train some kind of daily basis, the brain, the way of thinking. So I guess that we should practice and we should receive the blessing from His Holiness that every day we do a dental floss. So what His Holiness said that we have to invent the mental floss now. So that's why through the education we can floss our mind in a daily basis. So in order to bring this to a materialistic way or to make it very concrete and tangible, I think we have to come up with some of the concrete plan.
Thank you. May I invite Most Venerable Nawang Samten to make comments?
As I mentioned yesterday, this is a great historical event that the Buddhist Sangha community from Thailand and Sangha community from Tibetan tradition are meeting and interacting on various issues, which is certainly very wonderful. And I think this should be continued. And as His Holiness mentioned that we should have some exchange of monks from both sides. The monks from both sides should visit in groups to monasteries. The Tibetan group of monks should visit the monasteries in Thailand, and the Thai monastery, from the Thai monasteries, the monk groups should visit the Tibetan monasteries and how they study and how they debate and how they live their 24 hours life in studying and contemplation. That would, I think, certainly be a very important kind of thing for to get exposed to get exposure to the both sides of the traditions. And then besides that, on a longer term, we can exchange students and monks, students who can study Tibetan and who can study Pali and the Pali tradition. And we, in our case, we have a Pali department in which we have invited a monk from Burma who is teaching Pali in our university. We have, in fact, a great ambition of translating the Pali Tripitaka into Tibetan language. In fact, in Tibet, in 8th and 9th century, around 40 sutras from Pali Tripitaka have been already translated in 8th and 9th century, but now somehow it got interrupted in course of time, and now we want to translate the Pali Tripitaka into Tibetan language. For that purpose, we are training our young monks and lay students so that eventually they can become good translators of Pali Tripitaka. This is one of our ambition. Of course, it is a very ambitious project, but I think we will be able to do it in course of time. And as I suggested that visiting of students, as His Holiness has guided us, visiting of students from both sides would certainly be a very beneficial, and studying for short-term courses, like for example 3 months, 6 months, so 1 year, or 2 years, or 3 years of time would certainly be very beneficial. In terms of, I think, educating the lay people, I think it is very important for the Buddhist Buddha Dharma to reach out to the lay community. In Thailand, the lay community, they show lots of respect to the Sangha. And I think it would be certainly very beneficial if the Sangha in turn can give some courses, formal courses of 4 days or 5 days or 6 days course, in which during which they can learn not only the Dharma, you know, in general, but also some of the philosophical aspects of the Dharma and their daily practices, and how they can contemplate and how they can meditate with some meditational, you know, sessions. That kind of courses for lay people, if we can design such courses for, then I think that would certainly be very beneficial for the lay people to reach out the Buddha Dharma to the lay people in real sense. I would like to end comment.
Thank you, Most Venerable. Let me ask.
Your Holiness and respected Venerables, in fact, I don't have any special thing to say. The only thing that I like to make it very strongly point out to here is that this is a time where all humanity should come together. Likewise, all Buddhists should join together. So this is the time. And in fact, all the proceedings, the points raised as to how the Buddhist community can contribute to the humanity. So this is also well delineated by His Holiness the Dalai Lama, and likewise by Venerable Samdhor Rinpoche and the other Venerables. So I think this is the time, we are very fortunate to, you know, have a uniting force which brings all the Buddhists together. So this is His Holiness the Dalai Lama. This is indeed, we are very fortunate. So otherwise, the Thais, you will be all away there, and the Tibetans away here. So likewise, the Indians, the Westerners, and so forth, they simply remain separated. There must be a uniting force, without which this cannot possibly happen other than remaining as a part of a dream. But now, we are very fortunate that His Holiness is there as the uniting force, and we must make it a point that this united force be used in this time, and then we come together, and then we act according to the guidance of His Holiness the Dalai Lama. This would be really very productive for everyone. So this is the only thing that I have to say. Thank you.
Thank you, Geshe. Most Venerable Samdong Rinpoche, we would definitely like to hear your guidance and your wisdom on this matter.
Your Holiness, Venerable Monks and Dharma Friends, I have talked quite a lot yesterday. I do not have much thing to be added today. We have already started the joining of hearts for quite some time, and I think now we reach a stage of mutual understanding and closeness as a result of this congregation had happened. So for the future, now the question of joining hand, a conference like this may not be able to make a concrete proposal what we can do immediately. Since Buddhadasa Foundation and Archive have taken initiative for organizing this dialogue, and as mentioned by Venerable Sakya, this organization, the archive, should be a kind of facilitator or the initiator to make a plans what we can do in an immediate basis and what we can plan for long-term basis. After 2 days discussion, we felt few things. The first is the language barrier. To break language barrier from both sides, learning of Thai language, Tibetan language, and Pali, we must have some 10-friend program, which institution, Sarnath University, Tibet House, and Dharamsala Library, these three institutions in India for the Tibetans, and similarly some institutions should be identified in Thailand, and these institutions can join for 6 months course, 1 year's course of language training from both side students, and that can be implemented in the near future. And for long term, as mentioned by Honorable Vice Chancellor, that the Pali Tripitak have not been translated into Tibetan language, and we felt for quite some time the necessity. If entire Pali Tripitak could be translated into a Tibetan language, then the study by the Tibetans of Pali source will become much easier. When I was in Sarnath, one of my colleagues, Professor Simbadoji, have started the translation of Abhidhammati Sango from Pali to Tibetan, and it took about 3-4 years, and he has completed in a huge volume. The entire Abhidhammati Sango was translated into a Tibetan language, and which become a great source of Pali Abhidhamma for the Tibetan people. And then we started the translation of Bishuddha Marg, which could not complete it, and he left Sarnath, and therefore it remained untranslated. So if we could make a joint effort, when late Prime Minister Uno, he was exiled in India, he used to live in Sarnath, and then up later on he go back to Myanmar, and he started translation of Pali Tripitak into English, and we have a joint project at that time. Whatever he translates in Myanmar, and he will send to Sarnath, and the Sarnath will publish. In that project, we were able to publish only one book that was Dhammapada Atkatha, and which was edited by Burmese, and we re-edited in India and published from the Sarnath Institute. Then, due to certain changes in Myanmar and also in India, we lost that connection. So, with Thailand, this kind of problem, the political problem, is no more there. So I think we can do more work with collaboration in Sarnath Institute. And translation of Pali Tripitak into Tibetan language would be a great historical work in the service of Buddha Dharma, and also to bring the Theravadin and the Nalanda tradition of Sanskrit tradition could become more closer and more mutual understanding. And at the same time, some Thai students could learn Tibetan language, then Abhidhamma Kosha, and also some commentaries of Abhidhamma Kosh or Abhidhamma Samuchaya, the Sanskrit tradition of Abhidhamma texts could be translated into either Pali or Thai language. Then we can have a comparative study of Abhidhamma, of Pali source and Sanskrit source both. And I feel, although I did not get into the study in depth, but from the first impression which I get is the two tradition of Abhidhamma has vast differences and also which can contribute each other in a great deal. As far as Vinaya Pitaka is concerned, there's not much difference. The differences are of very minor nature. But in Abhidhamma study, the differences are quite significant, and therefore the Abhidhamma study of both sides can be supplemented with each other in a great deal. And then in the Sutta, lot of Sanskrit Sutta are not available in Pali, and it may not be relevant to all of the Bodhisattva Jnana Sutras need to be translated into Pali, but there are a number of sutras which are common with the Theravadin tradition and the Sanskrit tradition. So those sutras can also be later on translated into the Pali or Thai language that will benefit for educating the monks as well as the lay people in the vast field of Buddhist studies. And to get into these long-term projects, I think immediate after this dialogue, we should have a small committee or group of people, one or two from Buddha Dasa Foundation and one from Sarnath Institute and one from perhaps Dharamshala or Delhi institutions. So that small group can meet and make a proposal and agreeable and implementable from both sides, because proposals have a lot of financial implications and human resources, many things we have to work out. And for that, a small committee could be set up, then we could make a plan and seek His Holiness' blessing and approval, and then thereafter, without much further delay, we might be able to implement some things. And you have already mentioned a number of possibilities in your questionnaire, and the committee can go into the details of these proposals and make implementable proposal, and then thereafter we could work jointly. This much I wanted to say, and I will conclude. Thank you.
I think the majority of the bhikshus sort of agree that, I fully agree. I think should set one sort of committee, I think, immediate after. That I think, and then actually this is start join hand. That's very good, I think.
May I have some idea regarding the cooperation and exchange among Thai and Tibetans? Apart from the monks, I think that the role of lay people, especially in Thai society, is very important. In Thailand now, lay people play an important role in Buddhist education, in spreading Buddhism, and they are also they are also interested in Tibetan Buddhism. Many Tibetan Buddhism books become bestseller because of the lay people in Thailand who are very interested. So they are the big, so-called big market for the Tibetan Buddhism compared to monks. You know? Perfect. And even in Thailand now, we have some organizations dealing with Thai Tibetan. We have a Thai Tibetan center. It is run by lay people. We have a foundation that invite Tibetan masters to give a talk in Thailand. They're run by lay people. So, and the lay people is the force, so-called, behind the such dialogue. And so I think that in terms of exchange and cooperation, the more space and more opportunity should be given to lay people. For example, they should, apart from monks, and lay people should have opportunity to come and study in Tibetan Buddhist institutes, or to learn Tibetan language, and so on. Because I think that the cooperation between Thai and Tibet can be possible if can be there's more possibility for such cooperation can be materialized if lay people, especially in Thai side, have more opportunity to join in this endeavor. And I think that even nuns can be an important part in this matter. So overall speaking, I would like such endeavor to be to incorporate the role and opportunity both for monks, nuns, and lay people too, especially from Thai side.
Just adding to the Venerable Paisan, I think that I would like to request or suggest the Thai community here is that maybe it will be a good idea if we, you know, it's in a deeper level we can do that. But in a kind of surface level, I think it is a good start. As many of Thais, we love to come to India, to the four holy places of the Buddha, or even other holy places of Buddha. I think we should come up with a new idea that just add a few more days or add another route, have a pilgrimage to the Gompas in India, to the Tibetan centers in India. Then we could have a more kind of a close contact and we will know each other's cultures and traditions and how they do the things in a more fun way and an easy way. And then at the same time, as a Thai, we are, is always, you know, good at the giving dana, and we can support the Tibetan Sangha in, you know, directly or indirectly in one way or another. So that will be another idea, but very easy to start, very tangible, and then that is just in addition to the trip, we always do visit the holy places in India. And then why not have another route, a pilgrim to the Gompas, pilgrim to the Tibetan centers? I think that will make it the speed of collaboration even faster. Thank you.
May I invite Sangha from Thailand to give reflections on the recommendations and the proposals that we have discussed so far?
ขอโอกาสพูดเป็นภาษาไทยเพราะว่าถ้าเป็นผู้ภาษาอังกฤษเดี๋ยวคงคิดว่าคงไม่สามารถจะพูดได้ครบตามความคิดความมุ่งหมาย ตามที่ท่านองค์ไดลามะได้นำเสนอบอกว่าการให้ความร่วมมือระหว่างพระสงฆ์ไทยและก็ชาวไทยพร้อมทางทิเบตนั้นซึ่งเรื่องนี้เป็นเรื่องที่ดีมากถ้าเกิดเราให้ความร่วมมือแล้วก็มีการประสานงานแล้วก็ดำเนินกิจการต่างๆเป็นไปได้ด้วยดีนะเป็นเรื่องที่ชาวฝ่ายไทยน่าจะเป็นฝ่ายที่เห็นดีด้วยกับข้อเสนอขององค์ไดลาลามะที่นำเสนอมาความจริงแล้วเรื่องการที่พุทธศาสนาได้เผยแพร่มาถึง 2,600 ปีนี้เรามองได้ว่าพระพุทธองค์นั้นก่อนที่พระองค์จะเสด็จดับขันธปรินิพพานมีพุทธปรินิพพาน4ประการด้วยกันก็คือว่าขอให้เราชาวพุทธทุกคนนั้นได้ทั้งอุบาสกอุบาสิกาหรือพุทธบริษัทมีการศึกษาเรียนรู้เข้าใจพระธรรมวินัยอย่างถ่องแท้ประการที่2จะต้องมีการฝึกศึกษาพระธรรมวินัยนั้นจนรู้เข้าใจประจักษ์แล้วก็สามารถจะให้เกิดผลประจักษ์กับตัวเราเองได้ด้วยประการที่3ก็ได้แนะนำพร่ำสอนผู้อื่นให้รู้เข้าใจตามประการที่4นั้นเมื่อมีเรื่องราวเกิดขึ้นเป็นไปมีผู้อื่นโจมตีหลักการคำสอนทางพุทธศาสนาเราก็สามารถจะนำมาชี้แจงอธิบายให้รู้เข้าใจตามนั้นอันนี้ก็เป็นส่วนหนึ่งที่เป็นพุทธปณิธานเมื่อมีพุทธปณิธานอย่างนี้แล้วนั้นมาถึงจุดนี้ซึ่งเป็นปี 2,600 ปีของการตรัสรู้ของพระพุทธเจ้าเมื่อเราทุกท่านได้มาร่วมประชุมเสวนาในจุดนี้นั้นถือว่าเป็นนิมิตหมายที่ดีแล้วก็ถ้ามีการประสานงานร่วมกันต่อไปในอนาคตนั้นเป็นเรื่องที่เหมาะสมเป็นเรื่องที่เหมาะกับการเวลาด้วยในฐานะที่เป็นคณะฝ่ายพระสงฆ์ไทยนะก็ได้รับทราบข้อเสนอแนะขององค์ไดลามะที่เมื่อกี้นี้ท่านพระองค์ท่านได้เสนอบอกว่าถ้าจะมีการร่วมมือกันแม้ทั้งด้านการศึกษาด้านการวิจัยหรือการแลกเปลี่ยนนิสิตนักศึกษาต่างๆนั้นเราเห็นว่าเป็นเรื่องที่เหมาะที่ควรแล้วก็เห็นดีด้วยในที่นี้ถ้าเกิดว่าคณะกลุ่มชาวไทยโดยเฉพาะพระภิกษุสงฆ์ด้วยและประชาชนญาติโยมถ้าเกิดเห็นดีด้วยก็ขอให้สัทธสัญญาสาธุการขึ้นพร้อมกัน
สาธุสาธุสาธุ